Paramahamsa Nityananda is a rare living incarnation, a yogi by birth. He has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English, books in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian and Chinese, with translations in 26 languages are available. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 8,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services, ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world offer exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being, benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. Having meditation centers in 151 countries including Bidadi, Thiruvannamalai, Rajapalayam, Salem, Hyderabad, Varanasi, Los Angeles, Ohio, Seattle, San Jose and Phoenix. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, a spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation. A contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers. Adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, he has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands, gracing them with spiritual powers. A spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples worldwide in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places like Bangalore, Hyderabad and Thiruvannamalai in India. A dynamic young guru who is an inspiration to thousands of youngsters. India's most watched spiritual guru online. A beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment.
नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् नित्यमुक्तम् निर्विकल्पम् ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकम् वंदे शांतमयम् बंधम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम् आनंदगंध संचारम् सर्वोपाधि विनिर्मुक्तम् वंदे ज्ञानालयम् नाथम् नित्यानंदाय स्वागतम्।
Let me read the question. It was very helpful for all of us when Swamiji shared about the uniqueness of Hinduism. Similarly, can you also share a few words about your unique contributions to the spiritual consciousness of the world? I'll try to share basic few important contributions. See, if I have to answer your question completely, I myself, the unique contribution I have added to the Hinduism. Understand? The way I am dressing, the way the jewels I am wearing, everything is my contribution to Hinduism. I can say my first unique contribution to Hinduism is making the highest Vedantic experience as practicable yogic process. All yogic traditions stopped at a level where it never becomes Vedantic ultimate experience. All ultimate Vedantic experiences were having a gap between the practicable technique and the experience. There was no technique or a method to achieve the nirvikalpa samadhi. Till savikalpa samadhi, there was a technique. Means merging into a form or a name. Taking a quantum jump and practice from the beginning, which is based on the pure Advaitic experience and leading to Advaitic experience, which is in practice like yoga, but in ultimate experience as Vedanta. I have connected the gap between yoga and Vedanta, made ultimate Vedantic experience as practicable yogic technique. I can say, time will remember me for this just one contribution. You do not know the power and methodology and the unique way the unclutching technique was revealed. Many techniques starts very practical way, practicable way, like remembering a name or form and all that, but never ends in ultimate Vedantic experience, Advaitic experience. Stops in Savikalpa Samadhi. You will be merging with that one form or one name, Rama or Krishna or Shiva or Devi or whatever. And all Vedantic experiences like Aham Brahmasmi, Tattvamasi, those experiences have no start. All techniques and process and methods which has a start does not reach to that experience. My unique contribution to the Vedic tradition is unclutching. Starts with Advaitic understanding, leads you into the Advaitic depth, gives you finally the Advaitic enlightenment, making a beautiful, usable, motorable bridge between yoga and Vedanta is my unique contribution. My unique contribution to the spiritual consciousness of the world, first, making the ultimate Vedantic experience possible, offering a technique which starts with Advaita. It does not say, starts with repeating Shiva, Shiva, then move to Shivoham. No. It starts the moment you are initiated. You are an Advaiti. You are a Vedanti. Grows in Vedanta and merges into the ultimate Vedantic experience, making yoga into a practicable ultimate enlightenment science. The problem is, if you all are already exposed to the traditional Hinduism, then came to me after enough suffering and seeking and searching, then you will understand my unique contribution. But many of you guys are fortunately or unfortunately started understanding spirituality after listening to me. So that is the reason you don't understand my unique contribution. Tradition says, Sastra Jala Maharanya, in the forest of the dense, dark forest of the knowledge, if you are tortured, wandered in that forest for a long time, and then somebody gives you the shelter and takes care of you, then you will understand his unique contribution. Unfortunately, most of you guys directly heard me and connected. That is the reason you don't understand my unique contribution. First thing is,
just an hour's drive from Bangalore, Asia's fastest growing city. is a unique space of healing, meditation and rejuvenation. Welcome to Nityananda Dhyanapeetam. Experience soothing, healing energies under the ancient wish-fulfilling banyan tree in the presence of divinity. Enjoy the unique anti-aging formula of the original Siddha Healing Spa with the 21-foot energized healing lingam and healing pool, the Vaidya Sarovar. Connect directly to God in the vibrant silence of Nityanandeshwara Temple. Savor the delicious sattvic food served free at all times. Best of all, get a glimpse of authentic spiritual life at the daily morning satsang, worship, yoga and meditation sessions with Paramahamsa Nityananda. Rediscover yourself at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, the ultimate spiritual lifestyle destination. Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biridi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311. Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.
Vedanta as a practicable technique. Second, scientifically, logically analyzing, validating, recording all the extraordinary possibilities, experiences and expressions of Vedic tradition. Scientifically and logically validating, recording, preserving all the extraordinary experiences and expressions of Vedic tradition. Please understand, always this orthodox people never bend themselves for any scientific validation. All the new age gurus who are ready for scientific validation do not have stuff. My unique contribution is bringing that ultimate experience to the humbleness of scientific validation. with that ultimate, I am ready to humbly submit myself and all my processes and techniques for scientific validation, research and analysis. This is also one of our unique contributions. I can say my next unique contribution is being user-friendly. Please understand, all my kriyas, meditation techniques, process, everything is built with a material called user-friendly. Nothing is impractical. Even if I am teaching you impractical, I make it practical. Make you understand, inspire, elevate, make it into practical. So user-friendly is my one more unique contribution. I can go on and on and on and on my unique contributions to the Vedic tradition. If I go on and on and on again, you will be in a big mess of what to understand and what to share with others. So I'll stop with this. My unique contribution is first making the ultimate Vedanta into a practicable yogic technique. Anything practicable is always yogic, and anything practicable never leads to ultimate was the theory before Nityananda in Hinduism. I challenge, there is no Hindu literature. There is no Vedic literature which makes Vedanta into a practicable technique. I challenge any pandit, Purohit, intellectual of Hinduism. Of course, I have all my respects for Vedic tradition and Vedamata, but many fellows who think they are the representatives of Vedic Mata and Vedic tradition, I challenge them. Show me a single reference where the pure Advaitic technique, the moment it starts, it is Advaitic. When it is traveling, it is Advaitic, and it ends as Advaita. No. Advaitic experience is almost like having a baby where you conceive and allow it to grow step by step, step by step, step by step. Finally, it comes out. I made the whole system very simple, like test tube baby, removed. My unique contribution is making Advaita into a practicable yogic process. Be ready and working to validate, analyze, research logically and scientifically all the spiritual experiences and extraordinary expressions like techniques, methods, everything. And third, being user-friendly, trying to make everything into user-friendly. Fourth, this is one of the unique contribution to the Hinduism, I should say, connecting the lowest initial level concepts of Hinduism directly to the highest experience of Vedanta. Pouring a small little bit of water on Shivalinga, or putting a bell on a Shivalinga, bell leaf on Shivalinga, a initial level process which a villager starts. Even a villager, after takes bath, gets a pot full of water, pours on the Shivalinga, which is on the banks of the river. Connecting this to the ultimate Vedantic enlightenment experience without leaving any part of Vedic tradition, including all spectrum of Vedic tradition, making it as one living organism. Unfortunately, no guru was able to do. Either they are stuck with catering to C group, people who are only in the sense level, deity and puja, worship, homa, that's it. Or some are stuck just with the yogis, the B group. Do some kriya, technique, process, method, teaching. Or A group, giving directly the enlightenment experience. There was no guru who is able to play in all these three spectrums. Dhyana, our mission's unique contribution is able to play in all these three spectrums.
Eliminate stress from your life. Step up your performance levels. Enhance your clarity and decision making. Kalpataru, a unique full-day transformational healing program blessed personally by rare living incarnation Paramahamsa Nityananda. Harness the power of meditation and initiation. Experience a glimpse of Kundalini awakening for permanent physical and mental transformation. Take the first step to a happy and successful life. Kalpataru, manifest your destiny. Every weekend at Nityananda Dhyana Peetham, Nityananda Nagar, Bidadi, Bengaluru.
The Ingenious Program, a field of all possibilities. The children in the Ingenious Program are directly under the guidance of enlightened Master Paramahamsa Nityananda. Nityananda is an incarnation and exudes the knowledge of conflict-free living. He states that enlightenment is our birthright. What an incredible gift for your child, a once-in-a-lifetime privilege to live and thrive in the energy field of all possibilities and give enlightenment to your child. Where every child can become a genius. Learning can unveil the genius in every child, provided it stimulates higher order thinking skills, positive self-esteem, teamwork, and an internal locus of control. Research has proven that holistic teaching methodologies paired with meditation stimulate whole brain functioning and result in self-directed, spontaneous, and creative lifelong learners. An enriched environment. When young children have an enriched environment conducive to early learning in life, they have higher IQ, cognitive intelligence, EQ, social emotional intelligence, and SQ, spiritual intelligence. These early experiences are critical for the development of the child. Peer pressure and destructive social conditioning can take its toll on the child. It can create negative thought patterns and destructive behaviors unless these enriching experiences are provided. An enriched environment includes whole brain activities which stimulate the utilization of both sides of the brain. The right brain is responsible for creativity, intuition, spontaneity, quantum memory, learning in a flash, and computer-like calculations. The left side of the brain is responsible for inner linear thinking and analysis. When both sides of the brain are integrated, performance is optimal. Brain yoga. Brain yoga activates the ability to balance the right and the left brain. This helps open the sixth sense. Children are given activities to balance both sides of the body simultaneously using distinctive postures that stimulate both sides. The neurological brain patterns move from beta to alpha, increasing alertness and attention. Quantum memory. Quantum memory is a constant downloading of information without interference of the mind. Observation skills are directly related to memory skills. Reading without interference of the mind, reading at quantum speed, will lead to quantum memory without the mind getting in the way. creative and performing arts, dance, drama, music, sculpting and design offered in the Ingenious program provide kinesthetic motor stimulation to engage the brainwave patterns, resulting in expanded creativity and resourcefulness. Sattvic food. Children are given the benefit of fresh sattvic food prepared to the standards according to the ancient Vedic lifestyle. The food is fresh, with fruits and vegetables. Vegetarian food creates radiant health in the body. Vedic cultural arts. Sanskrit chanting stimulates the brain to produce full brain coherence, developing clearer perception and integrated thinking. Chanting also promotes inner silence and improves the attention span. Meditation and expanded awareness. Meditation instills a deep silence in the child, resulting in deeper, richer perception and clarity in thinking. Ingenious produces the next step in evolution, a mature human being who functions at a higher state of consciousness. Expanded awareness provides the platform for a vision of abilities of life, perfect health, prosperity, and life without conflict. What more could you ask for your child?
If I can just teach this one science to the kids, I will have millions of enlightened beings. I have been contemplating on the last satsang, thinking about chemical imbalances. Just being aware and realizing the chemical imbalance in the body for your actions can avoid the mistakes you have made in the past, and to realize you have a chemical imbalance can avoid your actions. How simple is this? Please understand. Just being aware and realizing the chemical imbalance in the body for your actions will completely avoid you even doing the actions. There are thousands of actions you'll just drop. As I said, you will lose interest in so-called pleasure. All the so-called interest in the pleasure will be lost. When the so-called interest in the actions are lost, you will not be doing again and again the same act, knowing it is going to put you in trouble. As yesterday I was telling, the same Brinjal story. You will not be doing the same actions. You will not be caught in the same pattern. Just realizing the chemical imbalance is responsible for the actions, many of your actions disappear. You do not enter into it at all. You will be responsible. Expand. You are saying, just realizing this imbalance will take you beyond your actions? Or is it just being aware of this imbalance takes you beyond your actions? Beyond what you feel in the action. It takes you beyond action itself. Not just what you feel in the action. Beyond action itself. Do you know you are from Las Vegas? I am not saying, be a lotus leaf which is in the water and water cannot touch it. Water cannot stay on it. No. I am saying even the action will disappear. How is this imbalance make you not responsible for your actions? We are responsible for the actions we do. How is this imbalance make you not responsible for your actions? We are responsible for the actions that we do. As I said, when you understand the chemical action, chemical imbalance behind every action, the very action disappears. And whatever you perform, you become responsible for it. You become very responsible and conscious, aware It is not done out of pattern. It is not done out of suffering. It is not done out of being caught. It is done out of freedom and responsibility. Never brings suffering as a side effect to it. This, only when you get in, you will be able to understand. Till then you will have a doubt, how is it possible? Get in, Diana, you will understand. I know the modern day youth is really suffering. Humanity has never faced this crisis. I have created a 1-year program where you can study the spiritual truths.
Nitya yoga practices to create healthy body, spiritual discourses to develop mental health, meditations that help balance emotions, kriyas to break mental patterns that create suffering, opportunity to express leadership qualities, techniques that improve creative skills. Learn to break all self-limiting barriers to achieve your dreams. Ananda Yogam.
I am providing a platform for you to think, meditate, contemplate and decide about your future. I am giving you 1 year free food, shelter, clothes, above all the spiritual education and intelligence and intuition to take decision about your future.
Every participant is taught the Vedic truths to live life as it leads, in a nurturing ambience, along with inspirational spiritual education that helps bring out the best and achieve one's highest potential.
Youth across the world can come and spend 1 year in Ananda Yogam to work on you, to discover your future, to discover your destiny, or recreate your destiny. I'll open my house for you for 1 year completely free. Come and stay here, discover and recreate your destiny.
Interviews at Nityananda Dhyanapeetam, Nityananda Nagar, Biridi, Bengaluru, 97422-03311.
Yesterday you asked to choose 10 patterns and drop them in the next 1 month. Can you please share how I can get rid of my patterns? Prema, just pick up 10. Decide this 1 month, I will vehemently unclutch from these 10 patterns. I'll allow everything else, but not these 10 patterns. Live with that one conscious decision. And continuously work to unclutch from those patterns whenever they arise in your day-to-day practice. For 1 month, you will see the 10 patterns just disappear and get destroyed. Before the patterns becomes your biomemory and organ and body part, break it. I have a story. One patient was entering the hospital. In the flower beds, 2 white-coated doctors are searching for something. Patient asked, "Sir, did you lose something? Have you lost anything? What are you searching? Doctors both of them replied, "No, no, We are going to do heart transplant surgery for income tax officer. We are searching for a suitable stone. So before the patterns become organ in your body, better unclutch. How patterns can become organ, you can see.